Thank you for taking the time to watch this video. My name is Glenn Olson. The purpose of this video is to give students a clear vision of the long-term benefits of martial arts. I hope you enjoy listening to the stories of our instructors as they share with you their experience with martial arts training.
Originally a karate kid, I started training in 1978 when I was 10 years old, and I've kept that training going pretty much my entire life.
I've been training for 29 years in Taekwondo.
I've been training for 20 years.
I've been training for about 12 years.
About 13 years.
13 years.
11 years.
9 years.
About 9 or 10 years.
10 years.
For about 8 years now.
Started Taekwondo 13 years ago when I was 5.
Started in the preschool program, and one of the first things I remember was when I got moved up to the big kids class after a little bit. Master Olson had a private lesson with my brother and I. 13 years later, I'm still excited to be in class with him and spar and kick him in the head.
My first day, my first week of Taekwondo, everyone was so encouraging. It didn't matter that I was the only white belt in the room, or if I was one of the new white belts in the room. It didn't matter how high a rank somebody was. Everybody was encouraging. It made me just feel like I could do anything.
Well, the first day I started training, I walked into the room, and one of the instructors held up a clapper target and said, "Christina, do a front kick." And I just stared at her like, "What?" And so she had to explain to me how to do a front kick. In the first few weeks, all I did was giggle at everything. And then after a while, I finally started to take it seriously. And I was like, oh, this is martial arts. I've really got to step up.
My favorite aspect of Taekwondo is sparring. And one of the things that I've liked so much about that is because I get to spar my brother, and I've gotten to spar my brother for about 13 years now, and as he gets better, I get better.
I could see how much we've grown and throughout the years as we got older and older.
It's been a lot of fun to spar together.
My favorite aspect of training is form, for sure. I love breaking down the techniques, finding why they work the way they do. So every single detail is really important to me.
My favorite aspect of training is self-defense because it helps me prepare for real-life situations. It makes me confident that if I do get in a real-life self-defense situation, I will defend myself properly.
I love forms. It almost tells a story or a fight scene, and so you have to make it your own and make it believable.
My martial arts training was fun, and then when I got into teaching, it was a whole other aspect of my martial arts journey. I truly enjoy it, just as much as kicking and punching, really. My biggest joy comes from teaching kids and getting them to make actually physical and mental changes in their life, whether it's getting physically fit or maybe gaining confidence. It's bringing that out in students that really brings the most joy to me.
You're here mainly for martial arts, but what you don't realize is how much you grow, not just in your training, but you realize how much you grow as a person. For me, Taekwondo's really helped me boost my confidence and being able to take charge and speak loud.
When I joined, I was really, really shy. I didn't like talking to people or taking leadership. I was actually really chubby as a child, so wanting to be healthy was definitely a part of it, and I also just felt really confident whenever I did martial arts. I think I'm way more confident than I was now. I'm not afraid to talk in front of people and take leadership. So I think martial arts has helped me grow as a person and a martial artist.
When I first started in Taekwondo, I was bullied. And just coming here and being with the Olsons just really helped me to overcome. Now I feel confident. I feel like I could stand up to bullying. I feel way better than I did.
Taekwondo has really helped me with my confidence level. In fact, it's probably been the most important contributing factor in my entire life. It gave me a way to speak out and really express myself because I'm not a very artistic person, but when I come here, I feel like I can just really gain that confidence that I was lacking before, up to the point where, you know, I could teach and lead people.
I actually enjoyed the little talks that we had in a circle when I was little, talking about anything from confidence to self-respect to discipline, and the word confidence always stuck with me. We just had a little 5-minute talk about confidence and what it did for us, and that's what I try to live by.
Most recently, I have earned my 8th degree black belt in Taekwondo, and I am a master instructor. It was a huge goal. I enjoyed the training, and I enjoyed preparing for it. Most of all, I enjoyed being able to perform with my brother in front of my family and friends, and I really enjoyed the whole experience. Anything worthwhile is hard. Over the past 36 years in training, I've had my share of injuries to overcome. I've had my share of failures to overcome. And you're gonna have those times where you're gonna have to motivate yourself. You're gonna have to look to your instructors to motivate you. You might even have an injury that you have to work through. None of those things are reasons to quit. It just makes you stronger and builds your character, and that's something that I've learned over the years.
If you want to be a black belt, it's simple. A black belt is a white belt that never quit.
One of our big words up at the front of our room is enjoy the journey. And I think that really applies to anybody that walks in this room, and even outside of martial arts.
Over the years, I have been so blessed with being able to work with my family and extend that family into the Taekwondo school and everyone in it. We try to build up one another and help each other and support each other when we need it. I want every student that walks in the doors to have that very same experience.
Everything in life has ebb and flows. I mean, there's good times, there's hard times, and really what martial arts teaches very specifically is how to work through those hard times and not to quit. Because there's things in life like college and having to go to a job that's very challenging. We can't quit those things. We have to continue on. And martial arts teaches that in a very unique way.
The coolest thing about my job is watching people like this grow up. It's pretty neat to see what confident young men they've grown up to be. Could be more proud.
There are lots of challenges and lots of struggles in martial arts, and everyone has their own, whatever those may be. But it truly is worth it to keep going and persevere.
Never give up. Just keep going. Just keep pushing through and enjoy the journey.
Seeing people do that is the reason why I keep teaching. Seeing them grow to love this martial art, and it really challenges me to keep going and keep learning as well.
I remember recently tying a black belt on a student of mine who, when she was a blue belt, she came to me and she wanted to quit her martial arts training. And I encouraged her to keep going. When I was tying her black belt on her, I asked her if it was worth it, if it was worth working through the hard time. And she was so proud of her accomplishment. She smiled huge and she just said, yes, it was worth it. And you know, that story has happened to me time and time again over the years. I mean, kids that maybe had a hard time with their training, something was hard for them, and they learned how to work through that time and accomplish their goals. You know, here we are 17, 18 years later. We have 450 students, well over 100 black belts, and it's certainly been worth the journey.
Thank you for taking the time.
No,
I'm gonna say it.
Okay.
Thank you for taking the time. Now, Catherine.
I'm sorry.
The purpose of what long-term training can do for them. Dang it! Yeah! Yeah! One of the great benefits. Achieving the black belt was amazing. Alright, I'm ready. I've been training.
Action.
Love Taekwondo. The elbow's out, and there's a...
What other interests do you have besides martial arts and cars?
That's about it. One experience that I and actually be able to tie his black belt back on him was tie back on him, his first time.